This watercolour painting was commissioned as a significant gift for someone with deep-rooted childhood memories of this expansive view. To evoke such memories many years later is quite a responsibility, and I was determined not to disappoint. As I stood side by side with a client surveying this breathtaking scene, he recounted his childhood days spent on the family croft. Of walking down by the water's edge, the sunlit days, the vivid colours in his mind's eye, the blue reflected sea, the rays of light in the sky, the glow of bright green grass against the dark waters of the sea, and the bright pinpoints of distant sheep dotting the landscape. I made notes of all these elements with the intention of incorporating them into the painting and produced some preliminary jottings in my sketchbook. Back in the studio, I subsequently produced a full-scale cartoon, a drawing in graphite of the proposed composition. Once this was approved by the client, its outlines were transferred in pencil to the watercolour paper. The paper had been stretched to prevent cockling, and the pure white surface now lay ready for the colour. Highlights were then established with masking fluid, and at this stage looked dark against the white paper. The whole surface could now be brushed with water, and the first layer of gentle colour laid wet in wet. This establishes the masses of the composition as soft solids. The balance of the painting as a whole can now be considered for the first time, and as this was satisfactory, was left to dry. Now the sky and the sea were re-wet in turn, and stronger values of colour applied wet on wet. The contrast this created in the sky now began to suggest light, and when dry the bands of sunlight were lifted off. The sea was graded in colour to suggest depth, to further reflect the sky. The land is now approached in the same manner, the soft darks beginning to model its surface. Colour is kept relatively clean and bright and tend towards yellow to suggest the quality of natural sunlight. The highlight colours having been established, the painting is now ready for shadows to appear. And here they are, in blues and purples. On the far banks, the lighter colours, left uncovered, sing out as bands of sunlight. To the right and closer at hand, the soft cool colours are the first indications of tree shadows silhouetted against the light. The masking fluid is removed from the details on the water, from the banks and the foreground grasses and the sheep to the right hand side. Where their edges seem a little sharp, they are softened by lifting away the colour gently. This can be seen in the washes of the boats and on the edges of the sparkling highlights. Details are now applied wet on dry. Note how in the final balance the sky is made dark to the right to provide the necessary contrast to the rays of sunlight. To the left it is made blue to reflect into the water below. Dark clouds to the right reflect dark grey-green in the water below, against which the sunlit waves can sparkle.